Okay, well hello, I'm gonna show my app, how to make, well I'm doing my app, okay, I'm gonna show you how to do your quick app, simply like that quickly. So basically I'm gonna start with a new one, I'm just doing my second one, okay, that's going, okay, I'm just doing, let me make a new one quickly. So we start on new, game 2. Just make it slow quickly, okay? One quick quickly. So just add the canvas. Just put what number, how much you want. I'm gonna do 395. This is gonna be a simple one. So there. Oh, sorry, it's the image. Canvas. 395. Then I'm gonna add score label because I want to do that. There, beautiful. And this will be automatic. Let's open the blocks. We want our text. We want, because we need to get, ball. I'm going to use the ball that I have, but you can use any ball you want. Or you can use the image sprite. And sprite. Same things, but the ball you can change the image. Okay. Then we're going to have blocks. Two blocks for now. Then add the blocks here. And okay, now upload the image. Okay, there, done. So go there and get our paddle. So here and paddle, okay. So this is, this is just two here. Okay, good. The ball is the interval how much times the ball changes image. So if you do 10, so the ball will be changing 10 times in a second. Or 10 times in a millisecond, okay? So this is the score, switch label, score label. Break one. Paddle. Okay, now I think we're all ready. Gonna wait for our open block editor to open. So the block editor is now all loaded and ready to go. We start with this. So when the screen, when the game loads, we want the ball to be heading. Wait, sorry. Okay, so when the screen loads, we want the new game screen. We want the ball to be going to any angle. Okay, just get that from your screen name. Then we want to head into any angle from 1 to 130. So a random integer from 1 to 360. Done, and there, so the ball will be hitting, the game starts, the ball will be hitting to any random integer from 1 to 30. Okay, so then we want to do our blocks. So break one, so we're gonna break class with good name break, so ball one, sorry, ball one. Okay, we want the ball to disappear. We want the ball to go away, so we call this enabled default, because we want the ball to go away. Defaults. Okay, and the other one we want enabled defaults also. Number two and defaults. I'm gonna have a score also. We need to have a variable first. Score the number one. Because that's not necessary, so it's supposed to be 0. Done, and so what happens here? Let's put that there. So when the blocks get hit, we want score to be added. Yeah. So we get the global score 0. Plus Yeah, so the same here, if you look for class with the break, if the break class is 4, you can scroll to you add one to the scroll group and the both points in this group. And we also both want the ball to be heading in a different direction. So we do go heading. So we want the set heading to call negative. Basically called opposite heading, and there we finish our brick. Okay. So we do the same thing to brick 2. So one brick 2 collides with 2. Go on, we just copy the same thing here, copy and paste, oops, and scroll, done. This is good too, done. Okay. Okay, now with the ball. So we want, when a ball hits one edge, any edge, we want the ball to bounce. So we want the ball, when it hits one edge, we want the ball to be called to bounce from that edge. Okay. Now to improve this, we want the game to finish somehow. So we have 4 edges here, and they have the same name, but they have the same numbers. So when the ball, we want the ball, so the game has to finish somehow. So the edge minus 1 is game over edge. Okay, so we do an if and else code program. The if and else, so let's put this here and say if the value of edge equals minus 1. As we saw from the other one, value of x equals minus 1, then what we do is call game over. So we do, you can just call, you can make, I'm gonna use a new screen, so I'm gonna call, we do call another screen with name x. Game over. This means we put another screen for game over, and there you have an the game section. What happens? Okay. There you have everything about game over. Okay. Basically, this is it for edge. Now to do paddle. So since I'm making this one paddle being touched, untouched, and dragged by a touch. So what sensor? But if you want sensor, just tell me in the comment, and I'll upgrade our sensor. So when, here it says when the paddle's dragged. So when the paddle's dragged from the starting point, and this is the previous point. This is the previous point. This is before the current point. Okay, so the current point where it is now. Okay, so we want the board when the paddle's touched moved. We want the board to move to where it is at the current x and y. So it's saying here when the paddle's dragged to the current x and y, we want the board to move. Paddle to move to X and Y. Okay. We also want the paddle not to be rotatable. We don't want it to rotate. Right. We don't want it to rotate, we just want it like that.